Many cities have shade ordinances that require more information on the canopy cover totals for the trees on your site. We'll go through two workflows with a few handy LandEffects tools in this short video. In this first example, the canopy cover requirements really focus on the shade cover for hardscape areas by individual tree. This means that one species could have one tree with full shade coverage, one with three-quarter coverage, one with half, and one with one-quarter coverage. On top of that, each species has a set expected mature size. The expected size is usually also defined in the city's shade ordinance rules. In this Excel file, we've broken the calculations down by tree size and coverage. I'll include this as a download with this video. Let's now see how to get the quantities to fill this in. I have a LandEffects planting plan here with all my trees already placed. I've created a series of coverage symbols at each of the standard sizes that I need: 35 feet, 30 feet, 25 feet, and 20 feet, all at 1/4, 1/2, 3/4, and full coverage. I save these into a custom folder in my plan graphics folder using the Save Block tool. Save Block creates the needed SLD and XML files to match. I've assigned each symbol to a reference node amenity in a certain RefNote division set up in Preferences. You only have to do all this once. From here on out, I can import all of these into any new project where I need them. I could have gone with concept plants or reference notes, but chose RefNotes for the ability to rotate the symbols more freely. Now place the appropriate symbol over each tree. Place a general hardscape reference note area over a polyline around all your hard surfaces. Now generate a reference note schedule to a spreadsheet to get your quantities to plug into this Excel spreadsheet to auto-calculate what you need. Insert your Excel spreadsheet back using Paste Special. First, select the area to insert in Excel. Hold Ctrl+C to copy. Make sure to freeze your regular plant block layers in your canopy coverage viewport or gray out the LK block line layers like I'm doing here. It just makes it easier to read. In the CAD Home Ribbon clipboard panel, use Paste Special. I like to include it as a link in case I ever update my coverage Excel file for future edits. We've also seen requirements that simply allow comparing actual tree footprints over hardscape areas and their overlap. In this case, you don't need to place all those symbols. Just create a general hardscape hatch and a shade hatch in reference note areas. Place the hardscape hatch, then generate tree outlines. Explode the outlines twice into arcs, then use superjoin on them to turn them back into polylines. Trim and join the polylines together with the hardscape outline as needed to create closed polylines for your canopy coverage hatch. Place your canopy hatch, then run a reference note schedule for your canopy division to show the difference. You can bring this over to Excel again and create any calculations needed comparing the two areas. You can tweak both of these processes for the requirements of your city, but these workflows and the Excel file are a great starting point. Find the example Excel sheet as a download on our website with this recording at landfx.com/videos.